Hello, everybody. Welcome to our webinar, which is about terminal decline rates. I am Enno Peters, founder of ShaleProfile. My background is in physics and in artificial intelligence, and for many years I've been designing information systems. Since about 2010, I started to get interested in oil markets, and especially about the shale industry in the US. 4 years ago, I started the website shaleprofile.com because I wanted to make it much easier for people to understand actual well productivity, operator performance, and other trends in this industry. That's why we still have a free blog with weekly updates on the major oil and gas basins. Besides that, we have an advanced analytics and data service. The topic of today's webinar is terminal decline rates. How do older horizontal wells behave after producing several years? Assumptions about these terminal decline rates have a big impact on evaluations and reserves, which is why it's a hot topic nowadays. And that's also why we thought it would be a good subject for today's webinar. Luckily, we start to get good data on the actual terminal decline rates. And that is what I'm going to show you today. It will be a little bit of a high-level analysis. If you would like to know more specifics, simply request a trial or personal demo with me. I will start with looking at the major oil basins, and then we'll take a look at the gas basins. There's also time for questions and answers, so simply type in your questions in the Q&A window of the Zoom session, and I will try to come back to it after the webinar. I do have one request, and that is that after this webinar, you will get an email with a list of questions. It should just take 1 minute to complete these questions, and it will really help us in understanding how we can improve these types of webinars. Okay, let's get started. Okay, so here you can see the list of dashboards in our analytics portal that are designed to answer particular questions. For today's session, I would like to take a look at the terminal decline rates dashboards. Let me click this button here to make the dashboard full screen. Here on the left-hand side, you can see a map with all the states that we currently cover. Together, these states are good for 99% of all the horizontal wells in the US based on current drilling activity. You can also see a list of filters here. We can use this part of the screen to make our well selection. So let's select the major oil basins. I will select the DJ basin, the Eagle Ford, the Permian, and the Williston basin. For today's analysis, I also only would like to include wells that start between 2007 and 2017. Some of these oil basins have a major gas window, so I would like to exclude gas wells as well from this analysis, which I can do here. Okay, here on the right-hand side, we can see two charts. The first chart shows the well performance of all these wells. It shows the production rate, the average production rate versus the number of years on production. The chart here below shows the annual decline rates, also by years on production. By default, all the wells are grouped by basin, which is why here on the right-hand side, you can see a list of all the four basins that we selected. Sometimes the Zoom window is blocking this part of the screen, so if that is the case, please move that window a little bit lower. Let me click here on the Eagle Ford to explain these charts in more detail. Of course, there are always tooltips available, and here we can see that the 17,000 horizontal oil wells that started in the Eagle Ford produced on average 250 barrels of oil per day during the first year. In the second year, this level has dropped to 91 barrels of oil per day. This corresponds to an annual decline rate of 63%. You can see that these curves are getting thinner over time, And the reason is that we represent the well count in the thickness of these curves. And only few wells have produced already so many years. At a certain moment, we also don't show the wells on our chart anymore if the well count has dropped below 500 wells, which is a parameter that you can control here. So how large are terminal decline rates in the Eagle Ford? We can see here that annual decline rates are going down and that about 5 years on production, wells in the Eagle Ford decline with about 24%. But this level keeps dropping until about 7 years on production, at which moment these wells decline around 14% a year. For the DJ Basin, we can see that the average production rate is far lower than the Eagle Ford, but that the decline behavior is very similar. Until about 5 years on production, after that, the level stays at a much higher level, at over 20%. Let me now select the Permian and the Williston Basin. These basins show the best average performance. But we also can see that their average annual decline rate is far lower than the other basins. At 5 years on production, wells in these basins decline by about 17%, but these decline rates keep dropping until about 7 years on production, at which moment they level off at around 10%. Let's now take a close look at one of these basins. I will select the Delaware Basin simply by selecting these counties here on the map. We can now see the 8,000 horizontal wells that started production in these years in this area. By default, they are shown by operator, which is why here you can see a list of all the operators in this area. Simply by clicking on a particular operator, all its wells are highlighted on the map. And also here, there are tooltips available that give a little bit more information about these wells. Of course, you can also click here to filter particular operators. The next question I want to analyze is how well performance and annual decline rates have changed over time in this area. I do that by grouping the wells by vintage. We can now nicely see here that well performance increased in this area as production rates got higher almost every year. If I click here on the 2015 vintage, the curves are highlighted here on the chart, but also the wells that started in 2015 are highlighted on the map. What is very interesting is that it looks like although we are seeing a major improvement in well productivity over these years, you almost don't see any change in decline behavior. One difference is that newer wells seem to decline a little bit less steep in the beginning. Okay, I now would like to do a similar analysis for the gas basins. So let me reload the dashboard. Again, let's start by selecting the major gas basins. I also would like to include the Barnett as requested by one of you. It's always nice to make the webinar a little bit more personal. Select the Haynesville, the Marcellus, and also the Fayetteville. I will exclude the Utica for now because it is a younger play with less data on how all the wells behave. Again, I will select the wells that started production between 2007 and 2017. And of course, now I would like to look only at the wells that produce predominantly gas. We now have to toggle this button to gas so that we can look at the gas production from these wells. Okay, now we can see the well performance of these four basins, and we can also see their annual decline behavior. This nicely shows that well performance in the Marcellus and in the Haynesville is outperforming the wells in the other two basins. Especially the Marcellus shows very nice long-term well productivity. Wells in the Haynesville start at even higher rates, but you can also see that they're declining steeper. This is also clearly visible in the chart here below. There is a strange data fluctuation here after 8 years on production, and I think that is related to the fact that the well count dropped significantly and that well performance changed over these years. We can see that the wells in the Barnett and the Marcellus show the lowest annual decline rates. At 5 years on production, wells in these basins drop by only about 15%. And this level keeps dropping until about 7 years on production, the annual decline rate hovers around 10%. For older Barnett wells, this level actually is even lower. And we can see here that these wells are declining with just 6 to 7%. I would like now to summarize the findings of this analysis. So we first took a look at the major oil basins, and we saw that the decline rates were highest in the Eagle Ford at 14% and over 20% in the DJ Basin. The Permian and the Bakken showed the best long-term behavior, and we saw annual decline rates level off at about 10% after 7 years on production. For the gas basins, we saw the lowest terminal decline rates in Marcellus and the Barnett, also leveling off at about 10% after 7 years on production. And for the older Barnett wells, this even dropped further to 7%. Another interesting finding was that despite that we saw major improvements in well productivity over time, we did not see strong changes in the decline behavior. If you're still here, thank you for making it this far. I know that there are many aspects that I did not touch upon in today's session. For example, I did not analyze how well spacing and EOR and refracking are impacting these decline rates. But I still hope that today's session gave you a good idea on the actual decline rates in these major basins. Let me now try to answer some of your questions. So there is a question here about whether these decline curves are averages or P50 values, and if they have the ramp-up periods removed. For example, ramp-up periods in a DJ basin can be 3 to 4 months before peaking. Indeed, in this dashboard, we only showed the average production profiles and also the average decline rates. And we simply averaged the production data by year, including the start of production, so not the start of peak production. There's also a question about whether terminal decline rates within a play change with lateral length. Also, this I think is a very important question. And in the basins that we looked at, for example, in the Permian, we see that lateral lengths increased by about 50% since 2014. But as we just saw, we did not really see a big change in terminal decline rates. So I think so far the preliminary answer is no, but I do think it is a little bit early to tell. I see another question about whether there is a relationship between terminal decline rates and well spacing. Also, this is a very interesting question. And actually, I've seen that in some areas, like in the older fields in the Bakken, it does seem that decline rates are increasing rather steeply. But in this particular analysis that we did today, we did not go into much detail on how well spacing is impacting these rates. There's another question here about whether I'm aware of any reserves consulting firms that are using 10% for terminal for oil wells. I must say, no, I'm not aware of that. I'm not aware about the actual rates that people are using, but indeed, I think that based on today's findings, 10%, at least in some of the basins, is a good assumption. I see another question here about whether terminal decline rates are influenced by reservoir performance or more by operating conditions on the surface. Also, this is an excellent question. And I think based on the data that we currently have, it is hard to say whether there is any such relationship. Okay, I would like to leave the Q&A session to this. If there are more questions, please keep asking them. You can also send me your questions by email, and I will make sure to respond to your questions. I would like to thank you very much for your time, and I hope that you enjoyed this webinar, and see you next time.